I feel nauseous, believe me. Never had a lot of shit come easy. Had to work hard, struggle just to be me.
Finished!
Awfully confident, aren't we? Then please, allow me to show you just how terrifying my true power is.
Is that all you've got?
Wait! That's 18! He spit out 18! He changed back! He's lost his perfect form!
How lame. That's it. It's all over for you now.
This can't be. This is not gonna happen.
What is he up to?
Not good.
You're all finished. In about 1 minute, I'm going to explode. I'm going down. Then I'm taking you all with me. You and the entire planet.
What?
Well, did he just say he's going to explode?
I won't let you!
You Only 30 seconds left!
No! No!
What are we gonna do? We gotta do something!
There's nothing we can do. We're done for.
Just 10 seconds left!
Welp, I guess this is the only option we've got left. I can't really think of any other way to save the Earth.
Goku, wait. What are you doing?
Later, you guys.
Gohan,
you did great. I'm so proud of you.
Dad!
Tell your mom something for me. Tell her I'm sorry. Sorry, King Kai! This was the only place I could think of to bring him!
It's gone. Goku's energy is gone. Gohan.
Wait! Where'd he go? Where's Cell?
It's over. You and your dad did it. Good work, Gohan.
But my dad!
Your dad did what he did with a smile on his face. He was proud of how much you've grown. Come on. Gohan, let's head.
This power! It's.
It looks like I hit Trunks. You're probably wondering why I'm still alive. Allow me to explain. I have a small mass inside of me. As long as that mass remains intact, my body can continue to regenerate. Once regenerated, I not only regain my perfect form, but my power also increases, not unlike Gohan's. This must be due in part to the Saiyan cells I possess and their impressive ability to increase one's strength and resilience with every near-death experience I have. I was also able to learn Goku's instant transmission, which, I suppose, makes me even more perfect than, well, perfect. You see, Goku thought he beat me, but instead, he's only made me stronger.
You're going to pay for what you did to Trunks! You're dead!
No! Vegeta!
You're as good as
so much for the Prince of Saiyans. You're next, Gohan.
Huh?
Ah! Say goodbye, Vegeta. This little game ends here.
No!
actually did it!
Way to go, Gohan.
That was incredible, Gohan! You did it!
I can't believe it! Cell's gone! We're saved!
Well, we don't have any Senzu beans, but Dende will fix them up in no time! Let's get him to Dende!
Alright, let's go!
Hey, Vegeta, you need a hand?
I don't need your help, understand? You better stay away from me!
Fine.
That's it. Kakarot and his kid are finally out of reach. Damn you, Kakarot! How dare you die on me and in such a pathetic way! I'm done fighting. What are those guys?
Mr. Satan! Where is Cell?
Huh? Cell? He's gone. I beat him.
What?
Those freaks are just prancing around with their flashy magic tricks. So I told them, enough was enough, you know, and I went in there and I showed Cell who's boss.
Oh, but where are the others?
Thanked me and they went home.
Incredible! So you mean the Earth has been saved from Cell's reign of terror?
Well, that's right.
You heard it here first, folks! Earth has been saved! And it's all thanks to our hero, Mr. Satan!
Mr. Satan! Mr. Satan! Mr. Satan! Mr. Satan!
It's okay. You're at Kami's lookout. It's over. Gohan took care of Perfect Cell. Everything's gonna be all right.
Gohan?
Yeah, he was unbelievably strong. Even you wouldn't be able to touch him.
You owe Krillin your thanks. He risked his life to save you once Cell spit you out.
Well, I couldn't have just left you there.
Oh, I think I get it! You like her, don't you, Krillin? You like 18!
Don't blurt it out like that!
So what, little man? You want me to hold your hand or something? Is that what you want?
Hey, what's your problem? Is there any way to treat the guy that saved your life? Huh?
Calm down, Yamcha.
We need to focus. We have to get all the Dragon Balls and use them to revive Trunks and everyone else who was killed.
Right.
Why did it get dark all of a sudden?
What is that?
Please bring back all the people who were killed by Cell!
Consider it done.
Where am I?
All right!
Interesting. I still can't sense Goku's energy.
State your second wish.
Wait! Can't you bring back Goku?
I'm afraid not. Goku has already been brought back from the dead once before. State another wish.
Well, there you go. He can't do it.
No. There's got to be a way. We can figure this out.
Hey, guys! It's me, Goku!
Goku?
I'm talking to you from Otherworld. Listen up. So, I was talking to Bulma earlier, and she mentioned the fact that I've always got all these bad guys coming after me. And when you really think about it, it sucks how right she is. All that's to say, I think it's probably better for the Earth if I just stay here. Don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to make a heroic sacrifice or anything. I'm actually getting some special treatment here because I saved the Earth so many times. Normally when you die, you turn into a spirit. But I'm getting to keep my body. Plus, I've got plenty of super strong people from the past to keep me entertained. Which, I'm not gonna lie, is cool. That doesn't mean I don't feel marginally bad for Chi-Chi and Gohan, but you guys don't need to bring me back. Gohan's already way stronger than me now anyway, so you'll be fine.
Dad, that's not true.
Gotta go. Bye! Okay, and make sure to look me up or whatever when you die. Bye-bye!
You know, if you ask me, he seemed awfully happy and upbeat for a dead guy.
I grow tired of waiting. State your second wish. Do you not have a wish?
That's right!
So what should we do? Are we going to wish for something?
Shenron! Can you make Androids 17 and 18 human again?
That cannot do. The Androids are far beyond the reach of my power.
Well, I guess it was kind of a long shot.
Why Android 17? I thought he was dead.
No. He was just brought back with the others killed by Cell, so he's alive now.
Well, then can you at least remove the explosive devices that they have implanted in their bodies?
That I can do. There. The devices have been removed from their bodies. Farewell.
Krillin, why would you wish for something like that?
Well, I felt bad for them, you know? I mean, who wants a bomb inside their body?
But why remove the device from 17's body, too?
Well, I thought 17 and 18 might be good for each other.
I don't think I'm ever going to understand it. This whole love thing.
You idiot! 17 and I are brother and sister. I told you to leave me alone, and don't think I'm going to thank you for removing the bomb. Ever.
Later.
Hey, she said later. Maybe that means she wants to see you again, huh?
I have no idea what's going on.
I'd be a lot happier, I guess, if it weren't for the fact that Goku's not here.
Well, I think I'm going to head back. Chiaotzu's probably worried about me.
Right. I'm gonna get going, too.
So, Trunks, when are you heading back to the future?
I think I'll stay one more night and get some rest before leaving tomorrow.
All right. We'll see you off tomorrow, then.
Mr. Piccolo, are you gonna stay here now?
Yeah, that's the plan.
Would it be okay if I visited you every now and then?
Of course.
Bye, Mr. Popo. Bye, Dende.
Stop by whenever you want.
My father?
Oh, yeah. Trust me. He was pretty upset when you were killed. He flipped out and went all berserk on Cell.
Wow. My father? He did that? I'm off.
Goodbye, Trunks. Good luck in your future.
Go on. Thanks. I'll do my best. You guys take care of yourselves.
Have a safe trip back.
Take it easy.
Later!
Hey, it's me, Goku! With Cell totally gone, Earth is finally at peace once again. Hard to believe that was 7 years ago. I can't help but wonder what everyone's up to. Well, look at that! Gohan's as tall as me now. I'd love to go a few rounds with everyone again. Stay tuned for the next episode of Dragon Ball Z Galactic Showdown with the mighty Majin Buu. You really don't want to miss it, trust me.
Gohan, how long do you intend to keep that look?
Since Dad died, I've been doing a lot of thinking. Trust me, Mom, I have my reasons.
Well, suit yourself. But for the record, I much prefer your normal look to this gaudy Super Saiyan business.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You know, you get bigger with each passing day. And you look more like your father, too.
You think so?
Your fashion choices are yours to make, provided you keep up with your studies. Understand?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I'm not sure where to start. Maybe Piccolo can give me some good advice. Hello? Thank you.
Later.
Piccolo? There's something I wanted to talk to you about.
Sure, yeah. But why are you still a Super Saiyan?
Huh? I don't really know how to explain why, but I'm trying to continue my training.
You still feel responsible for your dad's death, huh?
Yeah, that's part of it. I need to make sure I'm strong enough to protect the Earth now. That's why I'm still a Super Saiyan. I want my body to get used to this form a bit more.
I see. So it looks like I didn't need to worry after all.
Huh?
Since Frieza showed up, even after we believed he was dead, I always thought I had to be on my guard. But if Cell or some new android show up, you're the only one that has what it takes to beat them. So I planned on giving you a push in the right direction when you needed it. But I guess you really didn't need me to do that.
Oh, so that's what you mean. It makes me happy to hear you have so much faith in me.
So, you got a more concrete training regimen planned? Just being a Super Saiyan isn't going to cut it, you know.
Yeah, it's just... I still don't know what else I can do.
I guess that's understandable. You pretty much did all you could do in the hyperbolic time chamber.
Do you have any ideas?
With regards to your strength, you're probably as strong as you can get right now, so you won't see much rapid improvement in terms of raw power. What you lack is mental fortitude.
Mental fortitude?
Your dad, he knows how to remain focused in battle. You, on the other hand, you're still too emotional.
You might be right about that. If I had focused more, I could have prevented Cell from self-destructing. So, what should I do?
You might not like this suggestion, but why don't you try training with Vegeta? He's the strictest guy around when it comes to emotion. And not just with others, but with himself too. He might be able to provide some insight into the mental aspects of combat.
Understood. I'll go ask Vegeta if he can help me out. Alright, better find Vegeta so I can ask for his help.
What do you want?
Would you mind fighting me so I can get stronger? My dad died because of me. I need to get stronger, so something like that doesn't happen again. It's up to me to maintain peace now. I need to protect Earth in my dad's place.
Don't be absurd! You think Kakarot's dead because of you? You're the one that's going to replace him? You arrogant, spoiled little brat!
Huh? But I...
Damn it! I wasn't planning on fighting ever again, but I've changed my mind now. Come at me! I'll beat the arrogance out of you! I'm going to see if you have what it takes to fill in for Kakarot!
Okay.
Believe it!
Predator!
Nothing. We're done here. You were far more powerful than this when you defeated Cell. You were holding back, weren't you?
No, that's not true.
A soft, spineless brat like you could never replace Kakarot! Stupid child.
Yeah, Vegeta's right. I can't define who I am, based on who my dad was. I need to do some serious soul-searching. I'd better stay a Super Saiyan a little longer. Mom's not gonna be happy about it, though.
Greetings. Thank you so much.
This thing's filled with power.
Greetings. Yes. Let's see. What do you think? Thank you so much!
Right!
Excuse me.
Hey, Hey.
Let's see. What?
Sure.
Right. Yes. How's that sound? What? Oh ho ho! You! Very well. What? Indeed.